John 4 and 6 through 26 says, "Now Jacob's well was there. Jesus, therefore, being wearied with his journey, sat thus on the well, and it was about the sixth hour. Thus cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus saith unto her, Give me to drink. For his disciples were gone away unto the city to buy meat. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, How is it that thou, being a Jew, askest drink of me, which I am a woman of Samaria? For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans." In this passage of Scripture, popularity was defied. Jesus answered and said to her, "If thou knowest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, Give me to drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water." If we only knew the gift that God has given to us upon this day, we would freely partake of it. Verse 11 says, "The woman saith unto him, Sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. From whence then hast thou that living water?" She was being a bit of a smart aleck. From the pit of her brokenness, she was trying to defend her insecurities. Verse 12, "Art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us the well, and drank thereof himself and his children and his cattle?" If it wasn't enough that her emptiness was trying to be defended by her insecurities and her fear, she had to throw some religious garb to try to distract Jesus from the truth. Verse 13, "Jesus answered and said unto her, Whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again, but whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life." In other words, the water that the Messiah had to offer as a gift from his father to the Samaritan woman that was an outcast because of her relational decisions. He's saying to her in this verse 14, "My water, my love, is supernatural, and you'll never thirst for another love." Verse 15 says, "The woman saith unto him, Sir, give me this water, that I thirst not, neither come hither to draw." In other words, the woman said, "My emptiness is interested." Verse 16 says, "Jesus said unto her, Go, call thy husband, and come hither. The woman answered and said, I have no husband. Jesus said unto her, Thou hast well said, I have no husband." In other words, a husband is the head of the wife. And so Jesus was telling her in the 16th verse, if you're going to partake of this living water, you must have a head, because it is that the head that you drink, the mouth, the gate that you receive this love, the mouth gate. The woman said, I have no husband. Jesus just wanted to remind her that she had no head. Verse 18 says, For thou hast have five husbands, and whom thou now hast is not thy husband, and thou sayest thou truly. The woman saith unto him, Sir, I perceive that thou art a prophet. In other words, Jesus was trying to tell the woman, you've tried to have many heads, and you still do not have a head. The head is symbolic of authority. In other words, become your own head. You've tried it with many different men and never found that authority that your soul was thirsting for. Verse 20 says, our fathers worshipped in this mountain, and ye say that in Jerusalem, in this place where men ought to worship. Jesus saith unto her, woman, believe me, the hour cometh when ye shall neither in this mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father. In other words, she was trying to give the Messiah, even though she perceived that he was a prophet, she was trying to prove to him that she knew religion. But God was trying to give her a gift this day at this well, saying religion is not your head. Man is not your head. You must become the head, which means authority, and take authority over your emptiness. For God is spirit, so they that worship him must worship him in spirit and truth. The woman saith unto him, I know that Messiah cometh, which is called Christ. When he is come, he will tell us all things. And Jesus saith unto her, I that speak unto thee am he. In other words, your drink is here. May you partake of this living water today. May you become authoritative over the holes that are in your soul that keep you drained and keep you deranged. May you be filled by the truth and the Spirit of God today, and may you become the well of God's glory unveiled.